Other than having gobs of money, being a celebrity can't be easy. Sometimes people might be out to get you, or you might just want to vanish and stay gone. We don't know why, but these celebrities disappeared and are still missing today. At the time he went missing, Hale Boggs was one of the most famous politicians in America. A Democrat from New Orleans, Boggs had sat on the Warren Commission investigating JFK's assassination before becoming House Majority Leader during the Nixon years. Even though he looks black and white here, he had a personality that you could call colorful. He verbally attacked J. Edgar Hoover in Congress, he was thought to be an alcoholic, and he became famous for doubting the lone gunman theory of the JFK shooting. So yeah, Hale Boggs, kind of a big deal in 1972. Hence the nationwide shock when he disappeared. On October 16th that year, Boggs was in Alaska helping a fellow congressman's re-election bid. The two got on a light aircraft heading for remote Juneau. According to Medium, they were never seen again. The weather was terrible that day. As soon as Boggs failed to show in Juneau, everyone guessed what had probably happened. What was then the biggest search operation in U.S. history was launched, with 90 planes searching 325,000 square miles of Alaska. But no trace of the missing aircraft or its occupants was ever found. To this day, there are some out there who think Boggs was killed for his work investigating the JFK assassination. It's not like there could be any other explanation for a small airplane vanishing over water in bad weather, right?
Man, it's a mystery! It's a mystery wrapped in a riddle inside an enigma!
Were he anybody else, Michael Rockefeller's disappearance in 1961 would not have been big news. But he wasn't anybody else. He was Michael freaking Rockefeller, son of the famous Nelson Rockefeller. It may have only been because of his name, but when Michael Rockefeller vanished off the coast of what was then Netherlands, New Guinea, the world sat up and paid attention. The whole story is more strange and twisted than you can imagine. After a privileged upbringing, Michael decided to take a trip way out into the Pacific to both collect primitive art and maybe find himself. He wound up boating around New Guinea, the island today split between Indonesia and Papua New Guinea, and even made some friends among the local tribes. At least he thought he did. On November 19, 1961, Michael's boat overturned near the Azmat region of the island. The boys swam to shore to look for help, and that's it. Nobody ever saw him again. While it's widely assumed he drowned, at least some members of local tribes have told stories indicating he was killed on reaching shore. If you don't know the name Daniel Lynn Lagerlöf, that's because you didn't spend the formative years of your life living in the land of gritty Swedish noir fiction. A writer and director, Lagerlöf was the mind behind multiple Swedish classics. In 2011, Lagerlöf was scouting locations for an upcoming thriller project in southern Sweden, inside a nature reserve known as Sjörpannen. A wild and remote island just off the mainland, Sjörpannen is bleak, windswept, and not the sort of place you'd expect to easily get lost, all of which is why Lagerlöf's fate is so puzzling. According to Sweden's news website Local, Lagerlöf split off from his friends to investigate the island alone. He was never seen again. Sjörpannen is surrounded by water, so it's entirely possible the director slipped and fell in and simply vanished beneath the waves. He's presumed dead, but no body has been found, and no one can say for certain what happened. Officially, he remains missing. In a certain place, at a certain point in time, Zahir Rehan's name was known to millions. He shot to international fame in 1971 with his 20-minute documentary Stop Genocide, depicting the plight of Bangladeshi refugees fleeing the country's liberation war with Pakistan. It shone a spotlight on those suffering under a military regime that may have killed up to 3 million people. It also shone a spotlight on Rehan himself. In January 1972, barely a month after the war had ended with Bangladesh declaring independence, Rehan went missing. It's thought he was abducted by Pakistani security forces. After that, well, you can probably guess. The tragic part is that Rehan was only in a position to be kidnapped because he was looking for his missing brother. The Dhaka Tribune claims Rehan's brother was abducted off the streets of Bangladesh 2 days before the end of the war. When the dust of the conflict had settled, Rehan went looking for him, only to vanish himself. In another universe, Weldon Keyes is one of those names you got sick of studying in American Lit class.
What the f***?
A poet who tried to bridge the divide between Jazz Age experimentation and New Age madness, Keyes was someone who was always on the verge of making it big. Living in New York, he attended literary parties alongside people like the novelist Graham Greene. But Keyes never became famous exactly. The sad part was he disappeared too soon for that. Key spent decades failing to break into the literary scene, and by 1955, he was gloomily talking about vanishing off to Mexico and never returning. In July of that year, he told his friend Janet Richards, "Things are pretty bad," and mentioned going away. After that, he up and vanished into legend. The next day, July 19, 1955, Keyes's car was discovered by the Golden Gate Bridge. His wallet, sleeping bag, and account savings book went missing along with him. Who knows, maybe Keyes managed to forge a new life down south, away from all the pressures of literature. Check out one of our newest videos right here. Plus, even more grunge videos about your favorite mysteries are coming soon. Subscribe to our YouTube channel and hit the bell so you don't miss a single one.